It's certainly been in my mind for a few years, and Jim Beach, our manager, reminded me. He said, you know, you talked about making Love Kills into a ballad instead of a disco track. And I went, yeah, it's probably not going to work because you're probably going to hear the disco beat in his cans and you won't be able to get rid of it, etc., etc. Anyway, took it in the studio, get the reel out of the box, put it on the old analog machine, play it back, take everything out except the vocal, and it's crystal clear. It's absolutely pure. It sounds like he's singing it for the first time, and it sounds like a ballad. And this is called Love Kills. And you can think, you know, your first take on it is like, oh, Love Kills, it's kind of trivial. But actually, when you hear it as a ballad, you realize Freddie meant it. You know, love was killing him at the time. He was having a horrible time. Freddie was really in pieces. And so Love Kills was actually pouring out how he felt in a very real way. So I was very moved as soon as I heard this and started, what you can do, of course, is just weave a whole new tapestry around the vocal. And it's effectively, this tapestry is sort of half speed of the original, but it all works. You can do little things with the vocal. I twisted a couple of little things, I moved a couple of little pieces, which would have been a giveaway. But fundamentally, he's singing it as a ballad, and now the song is a ballad. Roger is drumming at sort of half speed from what he would have been in the old days. And it's got a strange kind of gluey heaviness to it. And I think it becomes quite a sort of classic Queen ballad in a sense. Johnny's on there as well, which is great. We found pieces of John to put on. But it's a real assembly. And I like it. I think the song has a lot of meaning. And I love Freddie's work. And there's times in the song he's not really spending ages on it. He's just letting it rip. He's in front of the microphone. He knows what he's got to sing, but there's some incredible notes that come out of Freddie, and it's so lovely to hear them very clearly without the big disco thing going on. But Freddie had a knack of taking you through different keys without you realizing. And this is very apparent on Love Kills. It changes, it metamorphoses into different keys. It goes up and up and up until in the end, it's just gloriously on the edge of what's possible in Freddie's voice. It's an amazing thing.